Uncle Joey Swether's Day in a Chinese Laundry by Mr. Charles Stewart. Well, I suppose I got tangled up the other day with just about southbound as looking critter I calculate I ever seen in my life. Well, I've seen all sorts of curiosities and monstrosities in circuses and menageries, but that was the first time in my life I ever seen a critter had his head and tail on the same end. Well, I said to a fella the other day, now whereabouts in New York do you folks get your washing done? I allowed when I left home I had enough with me to do me, but I've stayed here a little longer than I calculated to you, and if I don't get some washing done pretty soon, I'll have to go and jump in the river. Well, he showed me a place around the corner where he said a fella done all the washing, and I went around there, and there was a sign on the window that said, hop quick or hop soon, or jump up and hop or some other hop. Well, I went in, and there was one of them pigtailed heathen Chinese. Well, I told him I'd like to get him to do some washing for me, and he commenced talking some outlandish lingo, sounded like, nah, to it, Well, I give him my clothes, and he gave me a little ticket that he painted with a brush what he had. Well, I showed it to a fella on the outside. I said, mister, what do you call that thing? He says, well, sir, that is a sort of a lottery ticket. Every time you leave any clothes there to have them washed, they give you one of them tickets, and then you have a chance to draw a prize of some kind. I said, well, now, how much is a doggone thing worth? He said, oh, about 10 cents. Well, I told him if he wanted it for 10 cents, he could have it. I didn't want to get tangled up in any lottery gambling business. Well, he gave me 10 cents, took the ticket, and a couple of days I went around to get my washing, and that big tail he wouldn't let me have them because I'd lost that lottery ticket. And I said, now, looky here, Mr. Hopalong Field. If you don't hop around and get me my collars and shifts and other things what I left here, I'll slap you in just about a minute. Me come and see you, I'll do it, ticket. Well, sir, I got a hold of him less than a minute. We were rolling around on the floor. First I was on top, and then old Hop Soon was on top, and then I was on top, and you couldn't tell which one of us a pigtail belonged to. Well, when I got out of there, I had somebody washing in one hand, about 5 yards of that pigtail in the other hand, and old Hop Soon was jumping up and down and yelling, "Ah, do you, police, police!" I had an awful time with that heathen critter. Uncle Joey Swether's Day in a Chinese Laundry by Mr. Charles Stewart. Well, I suppose I got tangled up the other day with just about doggone as looking critter I calculate I ever seen in my life. Well, I've seen all sorts of curiosities and monstrosities in circuses and menageries, but that was the first time in my life I ever seen a critter had his head and tail on the same end. Well, I said to a fella the other day, now whereabouts in New York do you folks get your washing done? I allowed when I left home I had enough with me to do me, but I've stayed here a little longer than I calculated to you, and if I don't get some washing done pretty soon, I'll have to go and jump in the river. Well, he showed me a place around the corner where he said a fella done all the washing, and I went around there, and there was a sign on the window that said, hop quick or hop soon, or jump up and hop or some other hop. Well, I went in, and there was one of them pigtailed heathen Chinese. Well, I told him I'd like to get him to do some washing for me, and he commenced talking some outlandish lingo, sounded like, nah, to it, Well, I give him my clothes, and he gave me a little ticket that he painted with a brush what he had. Well, I showed it to a fella on the outside. I said, mister, what do you call that thing? He says, well, sir, that is a sort of a lottery ticket. Every time you leave any clothes there to have them washed, they give you one of them tickets, and then you have a chance to draw a prize of some kind. I said, well, now, how much is a doggone thing worth? He said, oh, about 10 cents. Well, I told him if he wanted it for 10 cents, he could have it. I didn't want to get tangled up in any lottery gambling business. Well, he gave me 10 cents, took the ticket, and a couple of days I went around to get my washing, and that big tail he wouldn't let me have them because I'd lost that lottery ticket. And I said, now, looky here, Mr. Hopalong Field. If you don't hop around and get me my collars and shifts and other things what I left here, I'll slap you in just about a minute. Meet him and see you. Ticket. Well, sir, I got a hold of him less than a minute. We were rolling around on the floor. First I was on top, and then old Hop Soon was on top, and then I was on top, and you couldn't tell which one of us a pigtail belonged to. Well, when I got out of there, I had somebody washing in one hand, about 5 yards of that pigtail in the other hand, and old Hop Soon was jumping up and down and yelling, "Wah, do you, police, police." I had an awful time with that heathen.